For most traders, Andrew's pitchfork is only about three lines: median, resistance, and support lines. But there are other lines inside the pitchfork that you can use to predict the location of future fractals in the market. These lines are derived from Fibonacci levels, which traders widely use throughout the world. The main Fibonacci ratios that we use here are 0.382, 0.5, and 0.618. We can use these lines to anticipate the reversal or continuation of a trend. You can create very profitable trading setups using these lines, alongside other technical analysis tools, such as candlestick patterns, harmonic patterns, Ichimoku, and many more. You can see that we've drawn a standard pitchfork by using three valid fractals in this example. If you are not familiar with drawing a classic pitchfork, I strongly recommend watching this video first. As you can see, the market reacts appropriately to the main lines of the pitchfork. But if we double-click on the pitchfork and check the 0.618 Fibonacci level box, it's evident that the price has bounced away from the 0.618 line several times and moved toward the median line. I chose the second example from one of my recent analyses on Stellar US dollar chart. You can draw Fibonacci parallel lines inside all of the different pitchfork types, and it shouldn't necessarily be a classic pitchfork. For this instance, I decided to use a modified shift pitchfork, and if you are not familiar with it, you can watch this video here. As you can see, the 0.382 Fibonacci level has proved its efficiency so far, and I hope it remains effective in the future. One of the many advantages of Andrew's pitchfork is that when you draw the median line and the upper and lower parallel lines and make sure that the market reacts to these lines appropriately, you can also use the images of these lines to predict the future turning points in the market. This technique is referred to as warning lines. To draw these lines, by using the support and resistance lines, we draw other lines which are parallel to them, and so that the distance between each of these lines is equal to the distance between the median line and the parallel lines of the pitchfork. The application of these lines begins when the market goes beyond the scope of a valid pitchfork. Each of these lines reflects the three main lines of the pitchfork, and each of them can play the role of potential support and resistance areas in the market. And of course, many trading platforms draw these lines for you. In this image, you can see that we've drawn a shift pitchfork using three valid fractals, which we got acquainted with in the previous video. As it turns out, the price reacts well by returning from the median line of this pitchfork. After the price leaves the pitchfork, we can find support and resistance areas by drawing warning lines, to which the price has shown many suitable reactions. Another type of pitchfork line that even many traders who use this tool in their analyses are unaware of is called Fibonacci warning lines. These lines are drawn in the same way as the standard warning lines, except that the distance between the warning lines is not equal and the Fibonacci extension levels determine these intervals. For those who are not familiar with these levels and how to calculate them, the Fibonacci extension levels are derived from this number string. Excluding the first few numbers, As the sequence gets going, if you divide one number by the prior number, you get a ratio approaching 1.618. Such as dividing 987 by 610. Divide a number by two places to the left and the ratio approaches 2.618. Divide a number by three to the left and the ratio is 4.236. And divide a number by four to the left and the ratio is 6.854. Of course, we do not know in advance what kind of warning lines and which levels the price will react to after leaving a pitchfork. But after a while and by examining the reaction of the price to different levels, you will reach a pattern that it will most likely repeat itself in the future. In this example, you can see that the price moves higher after leaving a standard shift pitchfork. And it seems that a strong uptrend has started that can continue. By double-clicking on the pitchfork and entering the values that we talked about, we find that the price has reacted to them. And in fact, the major turning points have happened around these levels. And if this pattern continues, the subsequent price reversal can occur somewhere around the 6.854 level. Another important line used in Andrews pitchfork analysis is called trigger line, which can be drawn from the base point of the pitchfork with the help of two other points. The line that connects point A to B is called the upper trigger line, or UTL, and the line that connects point A to C is called the lower trigger line, or LTL. Trigger lines can play a critical support and resistance role after the price leaves the pitchfork. In many cases, the price resumes its previous trend after hitting a trigger line or enters a consolidation phase. In this example, you can see that the price has reached the median line of a pitchfork and then retreated from there. As in the past, we can use other confirmations such as stochastic to ensure that the price returns from this area in company with the price reaching the median line. Therefore, we can go short below this valid fractal and put our stop loss above this fractal and use the lower trigger line as our take profit level. In the second example, as you can see, the price has moved toward the lower parallel line of the pitchfork after two failed attempts to cross the median line. After the price left the pitchfork, it started a downtrend. But when we draw the lower trigger line, we can see that the price has appropriately reacted to it. And in fact, the lower trigger line acted as a strong trend line, which has changed the direction of price movement. We can use warning lines alongside trigger lines to improve our analyses and combine these tools and other trading methods to achieve a comprehensive trading strategy. In the end, if this video was useful to you, please support us by pressing the like button. And don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button to be notified of new videos. Till next time.